Hello and welcome, my name is Emily, and today we're going to be playing The Beginner's Guide. Now, this is actually going to be a bit of a journey. It's going to be a bit of an experience. If you just sat down to this video, you may have noticed that it's probably an hour or 2 hours long, because that's the whole experience of this game, is you're supposed to play continuously for however long it is. And I've set the mood, you know, I got this nice little candle here. We're gonna have a good time, we're gonna hang out. I got some water, and I have some tissues, because I was told that I would cry. So, we're all good, we're all set here, and I'm ready to go. I will be probably I'll be checking to make sure my camcorder's still going, that my card isn't filled up. I do have another card that I can record to if need be. I'm not sure, I just got the new camcorder, so I'm not sure how much footage I can actually do on this card that I have. And I'll probably be stopping the video of the gameplay at some point, just to make sure that, because if I record too long, then it starts to drop frames, so I want to make sure that I don't drop any frames for this particular gameplay. So just sit back, relax, light yourself a candle like I have. It smells really good. It's sea salt and caramel corn. It smells friggin' delicious, and it's keeping my hands nice and warm because it's cold in here. And we're gonna have a good time. It's gonna be a nice little sit-down time. And I'll try not to make a lot of stupid jokes, because apparently it's a serious game. So I will be serious. Make sure your audio is on. Oh, it's on. I can hear the fire crackling, and it's nice because I can hear the fire crackling while I watch the flame on my candle. It's nice. I'm liking it already. Controls. Okay, and I have it full screen so I can get the entire experience.
Hi. Thank you very much for playing The Beginner's Guide. My name is Davey Reedon.
I should put subtitles on.
I read the Stanley Parable. And while that game tells a pretty absurd story, today I'm going to tell you about a series of events that happened between 2008 and 2011. We're going to look at the games made by a friend of mine named Coda. Now, these games mean a lot to me. I met Coda in early 2009 at a time when I was really struggling with some personal stuff, and his work pointed me in a very powerful direction. I found it to be a good reference point for the kinds of creative works that I wanted to make. So just to start you off, this is, I think, the first game he ever made. It's a level for Counter-Strike. You can walk around.
I was gonna say,
here,
it does look like Counter-Strike.
And mostly it's just Coda learning the basics of building a 3D environment.
I'm very low to the ground.
What I like is that even though he starts from the simple aesthetic of a desert town, he then scatters these colorful abstract blobs and impossible floating crates around the level.
Why is this black?
Of course, it destroys the illusion that this actually is a desert town, and instead this level becomes a kind of calling card from its creator.
Deep
abyss.
It's
like a reminder that this video game was constructed by a real person. And it kind of makes you wonder, what was going through his head as he was building this? This is what I like about all of Coda's games. I mean, not that they're all fascinating as games, but that they are all going to give us access to their creator. I want us to see past the games themselves. I want to get to know who this human being really is. And that's exactly what we're going to do here.
All right.
So, it's okay. 2008, Coda starts making these games, and he never releases any of them.
I need
he doesn't
to put
them
subtitles
onto the
on.
Internet. He just makes them and then immediately abandons them, and they sit on his computer forever. And I think he really understood this image of himself as a recluse. At one point, he jokingly renamed his computer's recycling bin to Important Games Folder. So, you know, this was just how he worked. He tended
Good
to crank them out one after the other without even really pausing to try to understand what he had just made, until suddenly one day, he just stopped. In 2011, that was it. He made his last game, and then he hasn't made another one since. And that's why I've taken this opportunity to gather all of his work together, is because I find his games powerful and interesting, and I'd like this collection to reach him, to maybe encourage him to start creating again. And if the people like you who play this also happen to find his work interesting, then I'm sure it'll just send that much stronger of a message of encouragement to Coda. So thanks for joining me on this. If you have a particular interpretation that I haven't mentioned here, or if you just need to get in touch, you can email me at daveywreden@gmail.com. Okay, that's about it for introduction. Let's take a look at Coda's first proper game.
Okay.
As each game is loading, right, I'll show you the date that it was completed.
I don't know how much
this
talking I should be doing
made
right now.
In November 2008.
Okay. Wait a minute. Can I turn on closed captioning? Got it. I forgot to do that. Okay.
Ooh!
Ooh! Alright, alright.
This game is called Escape from Whisper.
Alright.
And it's one of the more generic games you'll see from Coda.
Is that fire? Nope. Okay. Alright, so now I can actually talk some. So now I can actually interact.
You can click to fire the gun.
Oh. Bam, bam, bam! It doesn't make a noise, though. Pew, 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 pew! Hostile alien life form. I don't like that. Where am I going?
It kind of looks like this game was abandoned mid-development.
Yeah, I can't go anywhere.
For instance, you have this gun, which you'd think would indicate that there are supposed to be monsters or enemies.
There's nothing here.
But then clearly there are no enemies anywhere. You can't even reload the gun.
I can't even get in here.
Bullets.
Oh no.
But ultimately, we don't really know. Maybe Coda thought that actually it was complete the way that it is. And I think that we should talk about his games for what they are, rather than for what they're not.
Good idea. Oh, see, now I can go through.
I love how you can see the bottom of the universe from this room.
Hey, man, he tried. What if I shoot these? Does it do anything? No. I guess I can't do anything but look at the bottom of the universe now. Oh, no, I can't go through. Alrighty. I'm not sure, like, how much talking
Apparently
I should be doing because of this.
Labyrinth on it.
Yeah.
Sure, I don't know. There's really no reason
sure,
for it that
know.
I've ever been able to discern, so in the interest of time, I'm just gonna skip you on past it.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Okay, this is the part that's interesting.
All right.
The game has this narrative about the whisper machine and how it has to be turned off.
Yes.
And then you get to the engine room.
Yes. I'm here.
Hey.
It's pretty.
You there, in the engine room. You could save us all.
I could, but will I?
That thing is powering the whisper machine. We could disrupt it by introducing a great enough heat signature. If you... your body could stop the beam.
You want me to kill myself?
There's so much to ask, but for all of our lives... would you do it?
Okay.
Could you give yourself?
So if... I wonder if this is like an actual choice thing. Because I... like, if it were the fact that I could save people by killing myself, I would be that person to jump in the beam, but...
Let me pause here for a second.
Yeah.
What you just experienced, stepping into the beam and then dying,
yeah,
is probably what Coda had initially intended when he was developing this level.
Yeah.
But when he first compiles and plays it, something goes wrong. There's a bug somewhere. And this is what happens instead.
I explode. Or I fly off into the universe. I told you, fly off into the universe! Oh, I called it! Fly off into the universe. Ooh, it's so pretty. Now what?
The beam causes you to start floating.
So now I know how to get through the labyrinth.
Because yes, this is technically a glitch, but Coda identifies something human about it. Like how small it makes you feel in the face of this larger chaotic system.
It's the bottom of the universe.
The afterlife, a peaceful place, juxtaposed against all of the hysteria that you've just had to traverse.
I can't move.
I don't even know. I have no idea what he was thinking, but what's clear is that after making this, something lodges itself in his brain. He wants to do more of these really weird and experimental designs.
All right, cool.
So he stops work on this and moves on to a stream of tiny little games that go in all sorts of directions. Let's go ahead and take a look at the first game he made after leaving this one behind.
All right, let's do it. This is really interesting so far. I'm actually really, really enjoying it. It's, you know, I don't know anyone who's ever developed games or anything like that. So it's interesting to get a sort of sense of it. And I'm not sure if it's...
In this game, you can only walk backwards.
God damn it! The past was behind her. I was like, why can't I move forward? And then I realized I can only move backwards. And I don't know if this is actually... if it's based on the true story, if it's really fiction in the guise of a true story. But... oh, Jesus. This is gonna be difficult. I can't even back up in a car backwards properly.
So it's
but
a short and relatively minimalist experiment combining motion and narrative. It is less advanced than the previous game, but actually it seems to
Why
be
does the future keep
focused,
changing?
More complete. Coda is trying to give it a unique voice rather than simply basing it on a pre-existing trope.
That's interesting. When she stops and looks, it becomes clear. You're talking about me? I'm a girl. Am I the woman that we're speaking of? But the future's always behind her. Sorry, I told you that I wouldn't make stupid jokes and I'm like, meh, meh, meh. How will she find the strength? To confront it.
It's a short little thought, it says what it wants to say, and then it ends. Didn't need anything more than that. Which to me is why it works, because it gets out quick. Okay, next one.
Next one. Ooh, do we have to walk backwards in this one too? Or... Oh no, I can only see what's right in front of me. You are now entering. I don't want to know what I'm entering! Oh, this is becoming a horror film. Or a horror game, not a horror film. Nothing touch me, please.
And that's it. Okay, the meaning of this game won't be clear just yet.
Okay.
Please be patient with me for a few more games, and I promise you'll see what makes it interesting.
Okay, I got it. Nonsense in nearly every direction.
Oftentimes, Coda would put bizarre titles like this one at the start of his games.
Is that a staircase? That's a long ass staircase.
I wish I'd known him at the time that he was making these early games. He would really only talk to me about his work as he was making it. Once he stopped work on a game, like, that was it. It was dead to him.
Oh, that's sad, though.
And I don't agree with that at all, but what are you gonna do?
Yeah, whenever I make things, there's always a special place in my heart for them. Like, you know, sometimes I've made songs, I've made drawings, I've written things. I feel like I'm getting slower. I am getting slower.
Once you've been slowed to an absolute crawl,
oh,
the door
no!
at the top of the stairs opens. So why, if Code is not showing these games to anyone, why bother opening the door at all?
Will I eventually get there?
To show you, I'm modifying the game here so that when you press enter, it'll bring you back up to full speed so you can enter the door for yourself.
All right. Oh, thank God. I wonder if there even, like, anyone... Well, I don't know if this game was released, but if the game was released, would anyone actually continue up that staircase? Or would they... Would they just give up because it was so difficult? What? You start in a small room until you realize you can just walk through the walls. The game where you collect items, except the game automatically quits and you collect them all. These are all ideas.
A room that's warm and
they're little
nice
ideas.
And filled with little ideas for games.
Press U to surrender. You are the queen dusting your jewelry while the kingdom is destroyed. Play as the camera filming an advertisement walking around on set wherever you like.
Cold or distant. He said that he knew that he was actually a vibrant and compassionate person.
It's all very creative.
But it takes time to really see that. It can be a very slow climb to get there.
Captain's always wrong. You must address and rally a group of eager press reporters. A game where you collect items except the game automatically quits when you collect them all. Ready, set, fish. This is kind of creepy. It's a little creepy. Are you gonna tell me anything, narrator guy? Please tell me something, narrator guy. I'm a little freaked out. I don't know. I know his games are experimental. This is a little worrisome.
Well, this is new for Coda. It's an actual puzzle.
Alright.
Go ahead and see if you can solve it.
Oh, I probably won't be able to, because I suck at this stuff. Oh no, do I have to go in the darkness? Clickety click click clickety click click clickety click click clickety click click clickety. Oh, I bet. You know what I bet? If you... Nope. I just locked myself in. I was like, baby... Aha!
Don't forget that solution, because we're going to see this puzzle again soon.
Hey, it's the three dots again. What do the three dots symbolize? Because that was in the second one. Well, technically the first ever game that he made. Not the Counter-Strike, the other thing. I like that I solved that pretty quickly. I'm pretty proud of myself. Alright. Where to now?
So that seems to be it, right?
Yeah.
You walk down a corridor, you solve the puzzle, you get to the end. Simple enough.
What's with the light, though?
Alright. Now I'm going to modify the game again so that when you press enter, it'll remove all of the walls from this room.
Mmm! Oh my god, there's so many staircases and everything. What? There's a bunch of stairs.
How about that? There was more to it than we had any way of knowing.
He made all these stairs.
I actually find it funny that this game comes after the stairs game, since they essentially convey the opposite idea. So, in the stairs game, a dull exterior concealed a rich interior. And then, in this level, a dull interior hides this fantastic outer world.
But why? Why would he create this?
I think that the point is the same, is that most of the time, you don't get to know what you're missing, or even that you're missing anything. That's not your role as a player. So if your role here is not to understand, then what is it?
What? Can I? Okay, I was like, oh no, I hope I can't jump off. Hey, we're back here. Okay. So, the important part is not what I can see, it's what I can't see. You are now exiting. Before it was you are now entering.
Aha.
Aha.
So, this, combined with the entering game from earlier, tells us that Coda believes his games are connected somehow. It could even be that the stairs game and the puzzle game are literally connected in between this and the entering game.
That makes sense.
There's a bigger picture that all of his games are meant to play a role in. Some larger meaning that we won't be able to grasp until we've seen all of them.
That's really interesting.
And once we have, we can step back and start to understand what exactly that bigger picture
is. This is like a lot of artists and musicians also have this sort of thing where, you know, all of it's sort of connected, and I think that's really cool. I'm sorry I didn't read that. The great and something something. I was thinking about artists and musicians. It's a nice little house.
Let's talk about video game development for a second.
Alrighty, let's do that.
Every video game runs on what's called an engine, mm-hmm. which determines what the game can and cannot do.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, the engine cafe. Is a set of tools for game development.
Yeah. So, this game can't do anything, though.
To make all of these games, Coda is using an engine called Source.
It's just
like all engines, Source has certain things that it does well, and it has certain things that it does poorly.
mm-hmm.
One of the things that it does very well is boxy
linear corridors.
That's why so many of Coda's games are set in these large, flat, empty rooms, is just because he's working with what the engine does well.
Uh-huh. Makes sense. I want to see what's up here first.
The tools available to the creator shape what kinds of creative work they're going to end up making.
Open! Can't
open. Consider paying attention to the architecture in Coda's games to notice how they seem to stem from an engine that's very good at producing linear, boxy corridors.
It is linear and boxy. Can I go through this way? Nope. Alright, so we'll go down wherever that was to the more linear and boxiness. Right next to the toilet. Down through the kitchen. This is normal. Oh, I missed it. Totally normal. Look at all these random shapes. There's just random shapes everywhere. It's a good thing I can jump in this engine. This is scary all of a sudden. Oh, Jesus. Now where to? I don't know where I'm going. You gonna say anything, narrator guy? I'm just jumping. I'm falling! No, I missed everything! Oh, but I landed. I landed and it's okay. So that was all just a way to get down here. To a giant staircase. And a single... What is that, a light? A single light? It's protected by a barrier. I can't get to it. Where are we now? This is totally different than what it was. Something just opened. Oh, this gate probably right here. Why are we in what looks like a... Why did I hear a radio? Oh, it's just the music. Why are we here? What are we doing? Why are we in what looks like some sort of weird animal farm? Or prison block?
This prison, funny enough, in Coda's original design, the doors stayed shut for a full hour
oh my
before
God.
Letting you go.
Really?
If you don't mind, I think we're gonna skip
Yeah,
that.
Thank you. I don't really want to. Now what? Okay.
This Alrighty. Is something that he and I used to argue about a lot. You know, whether a game ought to actually be playable, whether it means anything if no one can get through it. And I would always defend that, you know, all this work goes into the game, why not make it playable and accessible?
Oh.
And so we just got into heated arguments.
There are some things from Stanley Parable, though, that are very inaccessible. Inaccessible.
And a day or two later, he sent me a zip file.
Playable games.
Playable games.
They're probably really stupid games.
Hundreds of individual games, each of which was just an empty box that you
walked around
in
and nothing else.
Believe me, I played every single one of those just to find out if there was like a gag.
Joke's on you, buddy. There was nothing. So, what that insinuates is that games are more than, and it's a very good message, that games are more than just things to endlessly entertain you, like with mindless actions. Games can also be art. They can also say something. They can have a message. They can be experimental. They can be creative, artistic, and sometimes the point of the game is that it's not playable. Sometimes the point is that there's things that you can't get.
It's the puzzle again, with the exact same solution as the last time.
Interesting. Okay.
There's still no clear indication of what makes this puzzle so special that Coda is going to return to it over and over.
Well,
but
I mean, it's
I promise
it's a
to
link.
Share with you my interpretation very shortly.
It's a link between all the games, so that makes sense. I'm exploring everything to make sure I don't miss anything. So sorry if I'm just wandering around with a face like I'm just looking at stuff. This is weird. Listen. Speak. You there, did you come from up above?
Here,
what was up there?
Coda begins using a kind of dialogue system that he fashioned out of the engine's chat capabilities.
Yes, there was a world stamped
with buttons on your keyboard to respond.
Yes, there was an enormous prison I spent hours in. Yes, there were these floating colored blocks. I don't want to talk about the blocks. Yes, there were these floating colored blocks. That's the world above. You've been there. Now this is important. Did you have to get through a puzzle with two doors and switches? Yes, I did. That was literally the last thing I did before coming here. I prefer not to tell you. After all, we've only just met. I'll be honest. Again, perfect. Now please tell us how you solved it. Tell us the solution. Tell us how to get to the other side. What if these people aren't trustworthy? What if they shouldn't get to the other side? That's kind of mean of me, but like, you never know. I don't remember how I solved it. I'm trying to remember, but I can't. I didn't solve it. Someone else let me in. Trust me, you don't want to go over there. Trust me, you don't want to go over there. I guess. Oh no, but I do. We do. We need to get there. Do you understand? It's the most important thing in the world. We have to escape this prison. So this is a prison? There must be an ending. I promise you, there's nothing I want more. So the other thing, the other prison, wasn't even the prison. It says a lot of things. Hey, look, and now we're back. It's just an endless puzzle. How'd you get here? Was there a puzzle you had to pass through? Yes, do you want to know how to solve it? No, we actually find the black space between the doors to be far more interesting. Have you seen it yet? Interesting, so this is a different room? Or it's the same room? I just went through it twice. Actually, now that you mention it, I remember feeling strange as I passed through it. I don't recall a space between the doors. I don't think there was one. Don't worry, I'm sure you will visit it again soon. Be sure to pay close attention. Is there a black space now? Nope, there's a staircase. It's interesting though that it has the little
and
boxes
so
that tell you what to
descent,
do.
Down to the final floor of the level.
I'm not going to claim to have any answers to anything that goes on in this game. It's more, I'm probably just going to be pondering a lot and trying to figure out exactly what's going on and the meaning behind everything. Oh, this was in the beginning. This was the lamp that was in the very beginning.
It's a lamppost.
It is.
Okay, I can't tell you quite why, but for some reason, Coda fixates on this lamppost.
It is right in the center.
It's going to appear at the end of every single one of his games from here on out. I'll tell you what I think. I think that up to this point, you know, he's been making really strange and abstract games with no clear purpose.
Can you go through any
and
of
maybe you can only float around in that headspace for so long. Because now he wants something to hold on to. He wants a reference point. He wants the work to be leading to something. He wants a destination, which is what this lamppost is. It's a destination.
Makes sense.
We're going to see it in the work as well. His games are just going to become a lot more cohesive,
cool.
A lot more fully developed, with more of a clear idea behind them. And as we go, that idea will get clearer and clearer and clearer.
All right. I'm ready for it. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah.
So I just realized I have Flux on. If you didn't know, Flux is a program that makes your computer less hard on your eyes at night, which is fine, because whatever. This game's connected to the internet. As you walk around, you can leave notes. It's just going to look different in editing. I'm going to be like, wow, it looks a lot brighter and whiter. Unless you see you're left by other players. Is it actually connected to the internet? Or is this all just not for real? Can I do anything? Nice room. Not. Are these all going to be mean responses and mean comments?
So first off, I'm sure you can deduce
how do you
this,
beat
this
game?
This game is not connected to the internet. All of the notes
they've
that
been
you're
written by
have been written by Coda.
No point to this.
This was actually the first game of his that I ever played. This was shortly after I met him at a weekend game jam in Sacramento where I grew
Whoa, holy shit.
I saw him working on this very level.
Wow.
And it was just so different
so
from
many,
anything that anyone else was doing.
So
right
so
away
many
I was like,
places to go.
I have to be friends with this person.
Can you guys hear me?
In retrospect, I think I was probably a bit too bushy.
Hello.
Trying to get his attention. I was over
reasonable.
But he was very gracious about it
everyone
and
this?
Very patient with me.
Hey.
And I cooled off eventually.
This place makes me sad.
Feel free to skip over any of these notes if they're not doing anything for you. Nothing extra is going to happen if you
Once
read
upon
all of them.
A time I did.
Either way, to
Define
me, it can be a
fun.
Sense of loneliness.
Yeah.
I see this person who's filled with thoughts and feelings and beliefs and has no way
Balls.
To express them except as scattered and unheard voices in a game that wasn't meant to be played.
Brrf, snuh.
But it's ironic, isn't it,
mm.
that in playing this game and seeing how alone
Do
Coda
not be afraid,
often felt,
do you care?
That we get to know him better and actually kind of connect with him. And I have to be honest with you.
No, nice. I would like
really
it when I could.
That I could just play someone's
like
game and see the voices in their head and get to know them better and have to be less of the messy in-person socializing.
Cool cavern, bro.
I could just get to know you through your work. I think this is why I always liked Coda's games so much, is because it felt like they let me have that connection.
They convey a sense of who
he
is.
He was inviting me personally into his
I can
world.
Type here.
And then I feel less lonely too.
Whoever there wrote much wrong. There are too many messages in this area. Why? It does convey a sense of loneliness because there's all these different little bits and pieces of thoughts. Everywhere, and he went everywhere to put these down. I mean, you know, you can, if you're developing, you can just fly around the map. I just saw a flying penguin. Let me tell you, it was the most majestic thing I've ever seen. I don't feel like living because nothing will ever be as majestic as that. I never want to see again if nothing will ever be that beautiful again. I am crying now and plan on ripping my eyes out. I must go now to do that. Yo, what? I want to read these all, but it would take so much time. What the shit is this cavern? Boring. I can assure you, guarantee, that there's an acorn somewhere here in this place, and the sailors are looking for it. Hey guys, just looking for someone to talk with. See, that is very... That's very lonely. That's... I don't know if this is actually like a legit true story or if it's just a butt-ass butt or if it's just, you know, this creator deciding to make something that would mirror a true story. I need to go to the frickin' bathroom. Recognize me, please. But it just makes you kind of wonder. There's nothing here. Go back. Don't listen to that guy. Makes you wonder about what goes on inside the heads of people who do create things like games, and mixed game includes door cannot open door things. Open sesame, it does nothing. Door how open? Someday I will meet the person who made this. Oh, geez, what is that? I help people because of the internal good feeling I get. Let me just... New room, yeah. Let me go ahead and look at this. I'm activating them as I go along. I failed to write anything here. Stop, turn back, proceeding further will only result in misery. Cabbage shapes our nation. Can I go over there? It does not matter if you ever get over there. But there's... Oh, I see. You gotta go through a bunch of caverns and things to get through there. Through to there. Next time I will do better. I need someone to talk to. This is a note? Don't listen to the other notes. I'm not safe. Hey, we're here. What is this thing, though? Why is there just this one painting in the middle of everything? Whoever made this has issues. And the narrator's not telling me anything either. I don't know how long I have to go. Cabbage shapes our nation. It's the same one again. It doesn't mean anything. Stop pretending you are other people. Who are all of you? But these are all by him. Well done, all of you. Today I learned you cannot fall off. Ah, so you can't. The notes are getting less and less down there. I saw a person walking down there and now it won't come back. There shouldn't be a person walking down there. Devil Tower Star. It's about how this game is pretentious and you all suck. Devil Tower Star again. So some of them do duplicate, which makes me wonder how many of these are the same. He was himself the most horrible creature he could imagine. By the way, like I said, this is like a journey, so I'm just gonna be going around and reading everything, basically. Maybe I'll feel real someday. Not everything, because there's a lot of these, but, you know, as I go through, I'll read some of them. We're all here now. There must be a reason for it, though. His terrible secret, he kept it well. I beat the game! No, you didn't. More room?
At the end of this level,
hey,
we're going to see the puzzle.
Scared of writing something, don't want to feel
and here,
judged.
I'll tell you what I think the puzzle means.
Okay.
Each of these games represents an idea that was on Coda's mind at the time that he was making it. And the puzzle is a way of closing the door on a previous chapter of his life before moving on to the next one.
And there's whispers, and I noticed that before, that the whispers are getting louder. But... like it was mentioned in the beginning, these are all just things that Coda himself was saying. Downward, keep digging.
In each of his games, after exploring a theme that, you know, he might find difficult, Coda can then place this puzzle that he knows has a reliable solution, he understands exactly how it works,
again.
And so it gives him a simple mechanism for moving on.
So he can move on to the next game, or does this puzzle have a solution? It does. You didn't... literally an hour, it's so easy. Unless it's different than it was. This doesn't make sense, the second door won't open. Oh, the second door doesn't open?
Because there's this dark area between the doors, a space between spaces.
No answer, I think.
Before
there's
you move
no second
on,
switch.
You get to pause.
Back to the
just
start.
For a moment. A few seconds to reflect on and let go of the events that led you here.
Should I?
To step back and connect the pieces
right.
together. To
I'm gonna be stuck here.
Elusive bigger picture.
There is a second. There was a second thing. They lied to me, there was a second switch. It's a typewriter. Why is there a typewriter? And we're back to the lamppost. Oh my god, there's so many typewriters! And the lamppost. Are you there? Please say something. It can't be anything I need. It can be anything. I just need you to say something. Talk to me, please. Why are you having so much difficulty talking? Speak, 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 speak. It's still going. Porn stars die too.
Okay, this one is tough. It's gonna kind of just spin its own wheels for a few minutes.
Okay.
Hang with it.
Am I a porn star? Do I die? Am I gonna die? My porn star? I live a double life I didn't know about? Like I said, I don't really have answers. I'm just pondering. So I may not have, like, things to say about certain things, like the typewriters and all that. It's more of just a reaction. I'm reacting to things.
See, like, this is it. The whole game.
We're at the bottom
and
of a well.
There's nothing that's particularly interesting about it. You just walk to the end of a hallway.
And now the hallway's gone.
Except, for some reason, Coda gets really fixated on this prison that has all of this modern furniture. And I don't know why, but he decides he needs to revisit this prison. He's gonna start over, use the same assets,
okay.
Turn it into something else.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Here's version two.
Alright. Now there's just no furniture at all. What furniture ought to go in the center of the room? Giant hole in the ground. Oh, a TV with surround sound. That's a table. That's not in the middle. Now what about along the wall of the room? 10 stoves. Let's put a huge picture of a horse. That's not a huge picture of a horse. You're not listening to my ideas. I think we should light up this room a bit. A skylight, full ceiling window. Let's open this baby up. That's already pretty open. We'll put live Tesla coils in each corner. Yeah! Skylight! Do it. Okay. Or don't. Thank you for listening to my input. And a table. You need a table. I already got one. Thank you. I'm pretty sure none of my choices are making any difference. Tables were invented in 1935. Oh, you actually did give me a table. And now everything's multiplying.
There's a bit more to this one, but still, it's not really communicating anything. It's kind of just weird for weirdness' sake.
Oh, I didn't even realize the well was... It is a prison where I go through and then I end up at the bottom of the well.
So, okay, he throws it out and starts over.
All right.
This time he comes at the prison idea from a different direction.
Okay. Please walk forward. I will do that. This guide will enable you to escape any prison environment. Follow the instructions carefully. Take care. I missed it. First, click on this table. Good. Go over to the photo frame and click to turn it slightly. The three dots are back. Now turn the floor lamp in this room off, then turn it back on. Boop. Boop. Now go to the left side sofa and move it over a little. Got it. Finally, touch the shelves. Where are the shelves? Where are the shelves? There are the shelves. Touch. That's it. In a real prison, the escape will now open. Return the start to be taken back to your prison. In a real prison? What do you mean in a real prison? Also, I like how the floors are now shiny. It's nice. Return. Okay. But that wouldn't happen in a real prison. Do I have to actually do this all over again? I don't remember exactly what it was. Table photo.
And of course, now
the table is
gone.
And there's no photo either.
Here's a version where there are no bars, but you can't actually get to the well.
Okay.
And then a version where the inside of the prison is the outside and the outside is the inside.
Oh my god. How many of these did he do?
Real quick through a few more of these. I mean, he really unloaded on this prison idea. There's nearly a dozen of them.
Really?
Personally,
we're inside the well now.
It's awful to watch this. To see a person basically unraveling through their work. And for what? Like, at what point do you just go, maybe there are game ideas other than this prison that I could be working on?
Upside down!
But Coda doesn't have that voice telling you to stop. That particular mechanism defense against yourself. Without it, you just spiral. And so he keeps going and going and going and going and going, and then he hits on something. And he likes it.
Yay!
And that's it. He's done. He stops making prisons.
That's nice. He got out of a rut.
This is the very last version of the prison game that he created.
There's still another prison.
And the reason I think it works is that the prison is not actually in it.
So how is it the prison game? I see the lamppost again. But... what does this mean? What is that I'm walking towards? It looks like a call box. Or it's just a door that leads to nowhere. Or it's a box. It's a box. It is a call box. I was right. Is this the prison? Is this the new prison? Bring, bring. Hello? Who is this? Hey, it's me. I'm you from after you escaped the prison. This is odd. You're me? So you were trapped in this prison too? Yep, I was in the furniture maze. Yep, I was in the escape tutorial. Yep, I was in the reverse prison.
And so this is what Coda wants.
Reverse prison.
To be able to talk to someone, to share what's on his mind, and to get some good
advice.
That's
where I am right now. Oh, well, I'm so glad to know that I get out eventually.
Even in this scenario, you're
still talking to yourself. What's it like to escape?
You know, all of these games so far are Coda talking to himself.
Feels like being completely still and wildly in motion at the same time. It's strange, but in a way, I kind of miss being in the prison. Actually, I'm already forgetting what being in the prison was like. 3. Do you feel any different? Sometimes I'm scared I'll get out, and then things will be exactly the same as before. No, I'm really the same person now as I was back then. It actually does change. I don't feel like the same person at all. Oh, good. That's so nice to hear. That makes me feel really happy. This is very sad in a way. Because it is really just him talking to himself. It's all just conveying loneliness. Age just kind of does that, you know? It's still me. I'm still me, but I'm not somehow. It's hard to describe. Remember to enjoy being who you are right now. It won't last. Wait, if you're me, then did you get a call from another version of you when you were trapped? No, I think I'm the first person to call back. Yes, I did get a call. That's how I escaped. What did they tell you? What did you have to do to get out? All they told me was to be sincere. They asked me how I felt about being in prison. They just talked to me for a while. What? They freed you? That freed you? How does that work? Listen, you can't know until you're out, but I promise it works. Just talk to me, it will make sense. Okay, I can talk. Let's just talk for a bit. Will you be here? I'll be here as long as you need. That's the end.
I can see why he considers this a fitting conclusion to the prison games. After all of the obsession and frustration, just to be told by someone you can trust that things are going to be okay, wouldn't that be nice? So what would it look like if Coda wanted to make a game about talking to someone other than himself?
Does he get to that point? I'm excited to see that he gets to that point. Because that means that he finally got out of his prison.
This environment is meant to represent Coda's puzzle, with the two doors on either side and a dark transitional space between.
Is there anything over here? Ah, it's the door up there. That's the puzzle up there. But what is this place? Oh, okay. That's a glass of something knocked over. Oh, hi. Hey, buddy. Well, my goodness, I'm glad as all heck that you showed up. Thought I might be having to clean this entire house all by myself. And right miserable that would have been. Everyone knows lonesome hands make lousy homes. Oh, so he's actually talking to someone now.
You'll notice that the quality of the art is a step up from previous games.
Yeah.
Including this new and improved chat system, which he started using from this point on.
Don't worry about me, a place this nice.
From here on out, he begins
putting
much more effort into the visual polish of his work. And this particular game took 2 months to create as a result.
And lousy homes make home loaners. Let's do that. Jokes! Ha! Something tells me you're going to be fun to do this job with. Well, this place isn't going to clean itself, far as I know. I'll finish up here. In the meantime, could you please clear the table? Clear the table. Did it! Much nicer. That's the table I want to see. Now, would you please run into the bedroom and make the bed? Where's the bedroom? I am on it, lady! Man! Lump of whatever. You're a dude, I'm guessing. I don't know. You could be anything. Bet! Bam! Beautiful! Oh, the art is much nicer. While you're in there, why don't you straighten out the rug a bit? All the details matter!
Beautiful!
Do you enjoy being a house cleaner? How'd you end up doing this job? It's been a long time since I've seen a house this messy. How'd you end up doing this job? Just have some small talk, have some chit-chat. A friend dragged me along at a time when I was particularly desperate for cash. Turns out I never felt so good doing something for money in my whole life. I have no reflection! Ah! Oh, speaking of... never did like cleaning my own home. I might have got some demons I ain't ready to face yet. Oh, speaking of demons, someone's put this couch all in a mess. Would you come out and straighten these pillows here? Are you gonna do anything, by the way? You're just standing there. I'm just doing all these things for you. Oh dear, looks like someone spilled a drink over by the couch. Maybe mop that up as long as you're over there? Yeah, you just do nothing over here. Over there, I'll be over here doing everything, because that's what my job is, evidently. Just checking to make sure I'm still recording. I feel compelled to share an incredibly cheesy personal insight. You okay with that? I'll try to get by. Make it especially cheesy. Put it on a pizza! Nothing? No. No, it was stupid. Sorry, never mind. Hey, these dishes need to be washed. Why don't you come do that? I feel like, in a way, he's still talking to himself. Also, check the tub needed a cleaning. How about you scrub it down as best you can? Scrub-a-dub-dub! Scrub in the tub. No need to be perfect. We're all just human. Are there still books scattered on the floor of the bedroom? If so, would you put them back on the shelf? Yes, they are. Ta-da! Pretty! Perfect. Now then, how about you come and clear these dishes off the table?
After the intense set of prison games, this house cleaning level almost feels like cleansing.
It does, but you just keep going.
It's after a particularly difficult or traumatic experience where you just need to let it sit and digest inside of you, and eventually cohere into something meaningful.
House cleaning is so difficult. How do you do it? Are all houses this easy to clean? Do these chores ever end? Darling, let me tell you something. Darling, darling, let me put my arm around you. In your lifetime, you are going to clean a lot of houses, and among all those, a few of them will stick out as truly wonderful, beautiful experiences, and none of them will be the ones that were easy. Just something to think about while you smooth out the rug in the bedroom.
Of all of his work, actually, this was the only one that he called me up to ask me to come over and look at it.
Yep.
This was during a period of a few months where he was like...
Looks like the tub's gotten rather dirty.
All the time. Just walked around with a constant smile on his face.
Earlier when I said I had a really cheesy thought, I was going to say that it occurs to me that one's house is a lot like one's soul. You take care of it and it takes care of you. That's very true. Don't know why I felt so weird about saying that. I get it, that's a weird thing to say to someone you just met. Yeah, you're right, that's pretty cheesy, but there's a bit of truth in it, no? Anyway, so, housekeeping. Let's keep doing this. Books, would you please clean up the books? Thanks. You're being very short with me all of a sudden, in your words. Oh goodness, those pillows over on the couch are a real mess. Would you go over and straighten them up a bit?
I'm glad he found some peace.
Yeah, me too. This is very calming. Should go over and straighten them up a bit. Question. Yeah.
But,
of course, enjoy this?
It can't last. The music stops, your companion is gone, it's time to leave. The door at the top of the hill is now open as well.
Oh, I really miss it now.
You can't stay in the dark space for too long.
But I miss it.
You just can't. You have to keep moving. It's how you stay alive.
It's true, but now I miss the nice music and the companion. And all the things I had to do. It felt good just to be moving, just to be doing something. Alright. And there's no walls. I just realized the walls went away. So that's the end of the... Because it's the end of the game, so that's the end of the... That's the puzzle at the end. As usual. As per usual. Oh, the puzzle's now gone. And it's the lamppost at the end.
Which is the whole point of the puzzle doors, right? That sooner or later you have to
pick up and move. There's a floating
tree! I
really
thought that was the point of it.
It's floating trees. Items you love at members only prices. Members only prices. This song gets a bit goofy, alright. Tuck, why did you come here today? We're in a lecture hall. I feel like I'm back in college. Oh, this is nostalgic. Was it to improve your life? Was it to get a better job? This is actually very nostalgic, even though I don't miss lecture halls, but was it to make your relationships more meaningful? No! You came here to be perfect. Alright, I did. I'm here to be perfect. Why am I moving places? This workshop is going to teach you how to be perfect. I want your friends, the people in your life, to look at you and think, wow, this person's a better human being than I am. Right now, who do you think about that way in your own life? my mother. Who do you know who is so well developed as a person that they make you feel disgusted with yourself, compared to whom you feel useless, selfish, ungrateful. I intend to make you into that person. Perfection is within your grasp. You only have a talk option. That's unfortunate. And the question is not how we do it, but how we do it effortlessly. This is easy. It is so easy. It is so easy.
About halfway through the
being
game,
perfect is effortless.
Shifts.
I become him. I become him. There's one person listening and everyone else is being sucked into the big void. Big void. Big void.
You discover that your teacher is just as bigoted and afraid as you are.
This is the key. How do I achieve it with no effort? Oh, cool. On the way to work, I told an elderly person to start contributing to society! Kids should not follow their dreams. Let me walk around. Hey, you! You! Yeah, you up there! And right in front of Sauron! It's terrifying. Well, let me tell you right now, if it isn't effortless, then it's not the right answer. I still love you, it's just that you make me feel cold on the inside. Being alone must be awful. So the two and the three are all inside thoughts. Whoops, I just moved my mouse. Thoughts that they can't convey. Well, let me tell you right now, blah blah blah, yeah. Thank goodness all of you perceive me as being wise and intelligent. Drinking is not hurting my life. If you are torturing yourself trying to find the right solutions for your life, you're not doing it right. Do you understand that you won't be happy until you love me? This is for you. Oh, that's not a good statement. Seek out only one thing. What is the easiest, simplest plan forward? Ew, I'm developing a cyst. Gross. Ha ha ha, just kidding. Anyone want to do some ecstasy after this? Hey, you and me, you want to go? Yeah. There's no truth, there is no path. Can I just, like, address the big void happening back here, or... What if I'm not a good teacher? Do what is easiest, do what is simplest, feel what is true. Holy shit, you guys! Something's coming out of the back of the room, look out! Yeah, you don't say. I'm surprised that person hasn't been sucked into it yet. Nothing, no one. It's coming for you, it's gonna destroy you! Everyone run, run! And yet I don't say that. I just-
pretty hard.
Perfection, perfection, perfection.
I feel like it's one of the most relatable experiences that you can have.
Saying things, and look, the lamppost is back there, I just realized.
Person is perfect and totally fulfilled in every
but they have their own flaws.
Completely miss all of the little flaws that make
perfection
them human. I think about this game a lot these days.
That's a very smart game. What was with the giant void sucking people
this one
in, though?
Took a lot longer than
this
all
looks
the
like the prison again.
It was 4 months between this and the last one.
I don't like the prison.
That's twice as long as it took him to make any other game before this. And it's not like it's particularly complex, so I remember I found that a little strange at the time.
It's just a lot of textures. And a lot of- it's an entire stage. This is so cool. If you've never been backstage, backstage is awesome. Just behind the scenes, doing things and everything. But this is a huge- this is like an opera stage. Like a legit huge- Ooh, that was scary. Alright, the performance is beginning. Places, please. Oh, this is terrifying. This is anxiety driving, and this scene you'll be playing is me, because you don't know what your part is. Oh, it's like one of those worst nightmare kind of deals. We're at a gathering of professionals. First, you start out leaning against this wall. But, like, you're on- it's a, that's a true nightmare, where you start- you're in a play and you don't know your lines, or you don't know what you're supposed to do. Good, stay right there. The woman across the room in this chair is a professional photographer of animals. This is your one chance to learn something from her, to gain something, to succeed. Go on, say something to her. You're rather far away. Hello. Hello? Hello, that's it? That's not a conversation. I'm sorry, I didn't mean- you need to actually converse with her, be a human being. Am I still leaning against the wall? Huh? I'm super, super scared right now. I like you! Here are all of my hopes and dreams! Super, super scared right now. No, 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 no! That's not what I said to her at all! You're completely missing the tone of the conversation. I was reserved, but I knew what I wanted. I was confident. For some reason, it was just that one moment, but I was confident. Maybe it's that you need a better feel of the setting. There are a lot of people around us. I'll give you some props to work with. These cones that bounce when you touch them will represent the people nearby. Am I still leaning against the wall, or... Boop! Oh. Boop! Yeah, boop! No talk to her again. You must have worked really hard to get where you are. I'll bet you've learned to lean into the pain. What are some sacrifices you've had to make? You're messing it all up again. You'll freak her out if the conversation gets that personal that quickly. Do you not realize how important this was for me? I'll never get another opportunity like this again. Everything was riding on this.
Hey, I like your titties.
Is that good? I want to try something. Let's try stepping back from the stage. Okay, it's a lamppost. Okay. How far back are we talking? That's pretty far back. I can't go back on the stage now. I'm very low to the ground, also. Alrighty, let's just keep on going. Okay, yes, now this is working.
This eerie premonition
is what I like.
Going to happen next in Coda's life. The solution, social anxiety.
I need to keep moving.
To fears of having to perform and having to chase success.
It's getting faster.
The answer for Coda is to withdraw, to hide himself away. Which is what leads to scenarios like the stairs that slowed you down several games ago, where it just becomes harder and harder to access Coda's inner landscape because he keeps retreating.
I'm still retreating.
He just keeps backing away from possible connections to anyone other than himself.
I'm really far away from her right now.
To be honest, I didn't consider it very healthy when I first played this game. You know, it looked to me like he was trying to justify the idea of just disconnecting yourself from him. And that wasn't what I wanted for him.
I don't know how far back this goes.
Because I feel like a lot of his games are inviting me to connect. To connect with this person. To bring him closer.
I didn't even think to look and see what was behind me.
But what can you do? After this, Coda went off and took another 5 months to make a new game.
Damn. And that last one took him, what, 4 months? Mobius strip, to play this game properly, you must keep your eyes closed. I can't keep- that's not gonna work. Captain, what can we do? Help, I'm blind, I can't see anything, what's going on? Something enormous just appeared on the radar. They're all blind, I can't die like this! I don't know yet, I'm trying to find the shields. I can't see anything! Are we gonna crash? What if you- but- SS Whisper. The Whisper was the first game that he made and it's the puzzle door! It's the puzzle door! Oh my god, it's gonna crash into us! I have to do something? I have to do something? What can we do? I don't know what we can do. Can't die like this, I can't die like this.
You should probably open your eyes if you haven't already. It's pretty much impossible.
I had my eyes open.
And there is a solution, by the way.
Is there? Push this guy. Research. What's going on? What's going on? I'm gonna kick you. I'm gonna kick you. Oh my god. I get in the escape pod and run away. That's what happens. I just get into the shuttle, and go up. Up, nope. Alrighty. I'll just get, yep. Don't mind me, deck 8. Alright, that's not deck 8. Look, there's a lamppost. The only way to stop it is to speak something that is honest. Truth, okay. I am bursting with creative energy. I can't keep making these. My work is always fun. I can't keep making these. Yes, that's it. That's the truth. I had a feeling that was the truth and I didn't really want it to be.
Like I said, I was getting concerned.
I don't feel it anymore. I'm out of ideas. It's draining me.
He's never been this explicit in his work about exactly what he's thinking. So, where's that coming from? But then, even weirder, his work has potentially stopped being an outlet for him. Not like he's having trouble iterating on ideas, but he literally just can't think of new ideas anymore. And in person, he was being a lot more distant than usual. Like, you know how sometimes a person will just deflect anything that you say in order to keep themselves disconnected all the time? It was that kind of thing.
You're doing it, it's
working. Here was the point in my relationship with Coda where I really started to wonder if he needed my help in some way.
Stuck in it. We're going to be okay. Do I have to speak anymore? No, I guess not. This is very reflective, this whole thing.
These games are going to get more desperate from here on out.
Oh, really?
After this game, it's almost 6 months before he finishes something new.
But it's interesting that it says you have to play this game blind. Or you have to play this game with closing your eyes. That means, like, you have to kind of close your eyes to what's going on. Hello, where am I? What is this? What is this? It's a pretty place. This is desperate. This is gonna be desperate. Where did this island come from? How do I get out of here? Hello, is anyone there? This is very cool. Oh, the music's changing. Is that a person? How lovely. It's been a long time since I talked to anyone. What's wrong? You look lost. I don't know where you are. I don't see you. You're not here. I'm completely out of ideas. When I try to create, I feel empty. I have nothing left to give to my work. Completely out of ideas. It's so pretty, though. Oh no. What's happened? Did something change? There was a machine that kept me going and it stopped. I'm trying to find this engine that used to protect me to start it again. Wait, you're looking for a machine? I think I know where it is. It isn't far. What? You have to take me to it. I need to see it to know why it stopped. Where did the thing go? There it is. I can take you to it, but there's a problem.
This last game featured Coda talking explicitly about his creative frustrations.
Scarred by just a difficult puzzle.
This one turns it up to 11.
If you can keep now, help me solve the puzzle, we'll find the machine, place. Deal.
Here's a friend whose work
no matter
is
what they does it, we're going to end up there one way or another, right?
Anxiety, depression, even.
Yeah.
And yet, still, he keeps making games. He keeps throwing himself into the grinder, even when he clearly doesn't have the energy for it anymore. Why? What is it for?
Come along, I'll show it to you. It's just... he needs something. He needs something to express what he's feeling. Give me a second. It just lagged for a second, so I'm gonna stop and re-record. Okay. And I'll stop. Well, no, that's fine. I can keep going. Alright. Perfect. Come along, I'll show it to you. But, the reason why he keeps making things is he needs something to say it. He needs something when he can't speak about how he's feeling.
Because, from my perspective at the time, and just what I knew of him, this was a result of how isolated he was. He was in his own little bubble, just sitting at his computer all day, not really showing these games to anyone.
I've solved this puzzle before.
Not releasing them onto the internet. And so he didn't have anyone outside of himself to connect with. He had no outlet
to
ground himself on.
Now what? And I have to... close the first door. Alright, what's next? He's like talking himself through this, which is interesting. Now just press the switch here. It should be that simple, right? And it works. That was so simple.
Can't
believe I never solved it before this.
It doesn't work that way. You can't be the one writing both the questions and the answers. Then there's no movement. Then there's no circulation. If all of your anxieties are being channeled into your work, then if the work ever fails, you have no backup and you're just going to crash.
Listen. There's... backwards. It's played backwards, but it's sobbing. What are you talking about? There's no machine here. These are just words on some walls. Those are your words, though. Trust me, you'll see. You have to say that your work is fun and easy. You have to say that game development is simple and joyous and that you love it 100% of the time. Okay, making games is simple. Sure, making games is easy. Alright, making games is effortless. But it's none of those things. Ah, that feels wonderful. But it wasn't true. Why did the walls just crumble? Why did I feel so awful when I said that? Don't worry about it, just keep talking. Keep saying that creation's easy. When I make games, I feel completely energized. I'm constantly excited and enthusiastic about my work. It's easy, it never stops being easy.
Seeing this game at the time that he made it, it looked really unhealthy to me.
Every time I make something, this is his way of coping, though.
And I hated it. I hated seeing him so trapped.
Every time I make something, I feel better about myself. Just never stop creating and you'll never feel bad.
Video games are not worth this amount of suffering.
Simple solution. That's true. Nothing's worth that amount of suffering.
And I used to get so much joy out of seeing him create.
None of this is helping.
For him to suddenly become angry and frustrated like this.
Where's the machine?
Worst thing for me.
Patience, you have to trust me. I promise this will work. Please continue. Pain breezes effortlessly off of me. Any sacrifices made for my work are worth it 100% of the time. It always pays off eventually.
I don't know. This is what I felt at the time. I don't know how else to explain it.
There's no shame, no fear, no guilt.
I wanted it to stop more than anything. I had never felt so rotten. I needed more than I had ever needed anything for this to stop.
No, I feel that. There's no shame, no fear, no guilt. I will be saved by my work. I believe this unquestioningly. I am a vessel for certainty. That's it. I'm free. But there's the person crying in the prison. And the thing with the prison is you can't get out. Remember everything that happened, you couldn't get out.
But it didn't stop. After finishing this one, Coda takes another 7 months and comes up with a new game.
That last one already hurt me. Quite a bit. I just feel like this pain in my chest. Ma'am, glad to see you arrive safely. Hey, I'm a ma'am in this! We've captured the machine, it's waiting for you now. We can begin the interrogation whenever you'd like. I intend to be quick, I intend to be quiet, I intend to be brutal. Very good. Just be warned that someone called the press, so we might have a bit of attention in this one. Also, one more thing that you should know about the machine, it calls itself Coda. So, I'm confronting myself, basically, if I were the creator of this. Playing it. It's an ugly looking thing.
And of course, it's the machine.
Mm-hmm. You stopped. He stopped feeding us. Your work was keeping us alive. Your work was keeping us healthy. So he's talking to his brain, basically. He's talking to his, not just his brain, but his motivation. Those people out there, can you imagine what pain you've put them through? It was only because of your creations that any of us could make it through every day. How could we possibly go back to trusting you to do this job? How about this for a start? You need to go to the people who are out there and apologize to them. You have to admit to the people that you allowed them to suffer. I've been so alone. Apologize for leaving me. No, nothing. Think carefully. I know how to hurt you. I've seen the thing you fear. Alright, then I will apologize to the people on your behalf. You shouldn't have to do that. My friends. It falls on me to deliver bad news. I have a troubling revelation.
The machine will not apologize to us. The machine refuses to admit that it deliberately hurt us. But this is not important. We're stronger than it thinks we are. We will find a way to live without it. We do not need its games. Is that, like, literally? Let us pay it retribution. Let us show it that we are not failures. It's interesting that there's the sound of an ocean. Follow me, we will destroy the machine. Follow me, we will destroy everything that the machine has created. I don't want to do either. We're back on the stage. That's an interesting twist. We're back to this. I mean, it makes sense. This was the first that he ever created. But I can't do anything.
Remember, you can click to fire the gun.
Oh. And it all goes away? Everything? Not the stage. Just this. Even this? All of it?
So now the work is becoming self-destructive.
Mm.
And I'll tell you, at the time that I first played this game, shortly after he made it, here's what I'm thinking to myself. I'm thinking that Code is stuck in his own head, and that it's having a very negative effect on him, and that all he needs to do is just start showing his work to people. To get some actual feedback on his games. It might get him out of isolation.
I'm still destroying everything. I don't know if I...
And so, as I'm thinking this,
I don't know how much I need to do.
I could be the one to initiate it. Because it would never occur to Coda to start actively soliciting feedback. So, what if I did it for him? If he could see the difference
that would
it would
be...
make to have more actual conversations with other human beings... Would that bring him out of his mental spiral? Would it give him confidence in himself? Would it bring meaning back into his work?
I don't like the fact that I'm doing this. That I'm destroying everything he's done. Especially this room. Oh, especially this room. Because this is the room that had all of his ideas, everything that he could have... Everything that he could think to do, to make. All of his ideas, all of his creativity was in this room. And
so I started showing
Coda's
work to people. I took this one, and the islands which you just played, the theater, the notes, the house cleaning game, and some of the prison escape games. I brought them to people
Can
that
I
knew and trusted. I asked their opinions.
Nope.
And the great part is that they really loved his games.
Good.
You know, the point of it all was just to give
it's
him some
puzzle.
External reference point, but they genuinely loved his work. There was nothing for him to be afraid of.
Put down your weapon. I don't have a weapon. Not anymore. Oh, now I have a weapon, and it's pointed right at you. I'm guessing all I can do is shoot. It doesn't work.
Can you see why I felt like this was the right thing to do? Because it's the thing that I always feel like I need, to be told that my work is good, that I am good. When someone really connects with a thing that I've made, when they see themselves purely in my work, there's nothing that feels better. And I got to give that very same feeling to my friend. I did something.
I don't know if this is doing anything.
I really felt like I'd done something good.
But I can't
like,
move.
Like, I was a good person. I felt like there was a friend who was in trouble and was unhappy and maybe didn't like themselves. And I could fix it.
It's not always that easy, though.
If I could give him this gift, maybe I could fix the problem. But and they told me how much they enjoyed his games. It was the best feeling. It was the absolute best feeling. It made me feel so happy. So beautifully, beautifully happy.
But what happened?
So anyway, Coda finishes this game, and then really he just kind of takes off for a while. So this is June of 2011, and I didn't hear anything from him for several weeks, I guess. And so out of nowhere, one day I get an email, and it's got a private link to a new game of Coda's. This one is called The Tower, and to my knowledge, it's the last game that Coda ever made. So let's take a look.
I know where this is going, and I don't like it. I mean, I don't know what the game itself is about, but just the wording. And it's lagging, and I don't know why. Sorry about that.
And this is where I have trouble saying anything meaningful about Coda's work. Because more than anything else, the tower just feels distant. It feels like it's trying to distance itself from the world. It's a very cold game.
But just the thing that is
this room
so
actually has a maze in it.
Really? Oh, it does.
Except that all the walls of the maze are invisible.
Oh no.
And then every time you touch one of the walls, there's this awful flashing and noise. So the experience is really miserable. The game goes beyond not being meant to be played. It actually seems to despise the player for trying to play it at all.
Okay.
But I do want to show you the rest of the levels.
Oh, thank
so
God.
When you're ready to continue, press enter and I'll put a bridge over the maze.
But I was gonna say before is that just the wording insinuates by saying it was the last game he ever made. It insinuates something that
and
I don't
And to be fair, it's
like.
Not like this is the first game that's needed some modification to be playable. Like the house cleaning game. You know, that one used to actually loop the cleaning chores and you just cleaned a house forever.
That's also nice.
To cut it
I
off
would do
so
that.
That. You could exit the house and the game would actually end. But that game had an idea that it was actually trying to communicate. What's the deeper idea behind the invisible maze?
It's just an obstacle. Something you can't see. Something intangible.
The only way past this challenge is to randomly guess the 6-digit code. Like the invisible maze, it's frustrating to me. Because it's the opposite of everything else that Coda has
2-2-1-2-5-7.
It doesn't encourage thought or engagement. It doesn't ask anything of me, except
a lot of my time.
If I could have reached him during this time, then maybe I could have asked him. But I couldn't. I still don't really understand why this is here.
Can you tell me so I don't have to do
I'll
it?
I'll put the code on the
Thank
ground
you.
So you can move
I was wrong. 151617. Oh, that's actually not even that difficult. It's just 1 and then a 5 and then 1 and then it goes up and then 1 and then it goes up again. Whoops. No, no! Okay. All right. This reminds me of Harry Potter. With the staircase just coming out from somewhere. I guess I drop down.
The switch to open this door is actually on the other side of the door, meaning
it's
that
impossible.
It's literally impossible to solve from this side. So even if you somehow brute-forced your way through the first two challenges, and you got to this point, there's actually just no way to progress. And it's scary for me, the idea of Coda cutting himself off entirely, just saying, you know, that's it, that's the end of the conversation, not giving me any way to fix the problem. I feel like a failure, I guess, when I can't fix the problem. But I can open this door for you, so let me do that.
There's a switch.
Was I a failure for not understanding this game?
No, you weren't.
I don't know why I would be. It's not like everything needs to have a solution, but I feel it somehow.
It's hard to understand.
I feel like I failed,
people.
And I don't understand why.
There's no reason to feel like a failure when you just, it's... You can't know what someone is going through unless you're that person. So, you can't understand exactly what they're trying to convey unless...
I remember. It's June of
unless you're in their head.
I'm playing this for the very first time. And as I'm playing, I'm thinking to myself, I don't know this person. I have no idea who this person is. It wasn't the guy I knew. It wasn't my friend. I had come to so many conclusions from looking at all of his work up to this point, and then suddenly none of them... I had been trying to, though. That was the thing. For years, I was trying to get to know him, to understand who he actually was and what he stood for. I asked him so many times to please just tell me what his games mean to him. I asked him please to tell me what the three dots mean.
I was wondering about that.
And he wouldn't.
Three dots.
I just felt so strongly that if I could have connected with him, that if I could have somehow made his work my own, that I would finally be once and for all happy. It was that I needed to see myself in someone else. I needed to be someone other than me. But he stopped and left. And it felt somehow like I had failed.
So it's, you know, not even about... It's not even just about Coda anymore, it's about... him as well. You didn't screw up. You couldn't have known.
I'm the reason that you stopped making games, aren't I? It's because of what I did. I poisoned it for you.
I'm glad someone told me to get tissues. I feel like my mother, she cries whenever she watches
things.
But
when I took your work and I was showing it to people, it actually felt... It felt as though I were responsible for something important and valuable.
Sorry. Also, I'm glad my makeup is waterproof for the most part.
And the people who played them, they treated me like I was important. They really listened and cared about what I had to say. Even though I was showing your work, it was... I felt good about myself. Finally, for a moment, while I had that, I liked myself.
Adding lampposts to them.
And then you stopped. And I didn't have anything left to show people. I just had to be with myself. And as soon as that happened, there was no feeling at all. Nothing. Less than nothing. What does that mean?
So it's become not about Coda, it's about him. It's not about Coda anymore. Well, it's about both of them. Or it's about him projecting himself onto Coda. More about you than about me, yeah.
I'm afraid that I did something really stupid because I don't like myself.
Sorry, I feel like I should be saying these. Saying what these say. But you can read. What's gonna happen when I do this puzzle? There's no switch
That's
on the other side.
That's why I'm releasing this collection of your work. Is because I haven't been able to find any other way to reach you. I've tried everything. And so a part of me has hope that if I put this compilation out into the world, and if I put my name on it, that maybe enough people will play it so that it'll find its way to you, so that I can tell you that I'm sorry. I know I screwed up. If I apologize to you truly and deeply, will you start making games again? Please, I need to feel okay with myself again. And I always felt okay as long as I had your work to see myself in. I mean, is something wrong with me? Because I know that I did an awful thing, and I'm doing it again right now. Like, I'm showing people your work, but I can't stop myself from doing it. That's how badly I need to feel something again. Like, I'm an addict. There has to be something wrong with me. Can I apologize? What if I tell you I was wrong? Will that work? Will that fix it? I don't know. I don't think it will, but there's nothing else that I can do. Just tell me what you want. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Please, start making games again. Please help me. Please give me some of whatever it is that makes you complete. I want whatever that wholeness is that you just summoned out of nothing and you put into your work. You were complete in some way that I never was. And I want to know how to be a good person. I want to know how not to hate myself. Please. I'm fading, and all I want is to know that I'm going to be okay.
Sorry, I don't have much to say. It's a lamppost, but it's a big lamppost. I don't know where we are now. Train station.
More love, more praise, more people telling me that I'm good. Always more.
Train station.
It's like a disease.
What kind of a train station are we in? Oh no, okay, I think they have these in America too, sorry. I was just thinking that this is like in Japan, they have these everywhere where it shows you where there's... where the sidewalk stops and things like that for blind people, but... I think they have that everywhere for at train stations.
Solution.
Where are we now?
I guess if someone had told me ahead of time that he just really enjoyed making prison games, maybe I wouldn't have thought he was so desperate. I wouldn't have told so many people that he was depressed. Maybe he just likes making prisons.
Like I said, sorry, I don't have much to say. I'm just experiencing at the moment. I just need to know.
Even now,
what
the
happens?
Disease is telling me to stop. Don't show people what a shitty person you are. They'll
I'm
hate
not
you.
A shitty person. No one's gonna hate you. Where's this go? Where are we?
If if I knew that my life depended on finding something to be driven by other than validation, what would that even be? It's strange, but the thought of not being driven by external validation is unthinkable. Like, I actually cannot conceive of what that would be like.
It's... I don't know. I would tell you, but... I don't even know myself. I feel like I have been in that place where there's nothing that I really like about myself, so I need other people to tell me how likable I am.
What now?
I've definitely been in that place. So...
I think I need to go.
Go and where?
I'm sorry, because I know that I said that I would be here and I would walk you through this, but I'm starting to feel like I have a lot of work to do. I have a lot that I need to make up for. So I'm... just... gonna...
I mean, you don't need to. I would prefer you didn't. I mean, even with things that you've done in the past, that doesn't define who you are as a person. What defines you is the present. And who you are now. And my camera is out of... It's out. Let me put in a new card. Let me compose myself. Now that I put my new card in. I gotta fix this. But, like I was saying, you know, you don't... Maybe you feel like there's things you should make up for. But just do so by being the best that you can be now. Don't just dwell on it. Don't try to make up for it. Just be everything you can be now. And I wish that you would come back, Mr. Narrator Guy. Because I feel like that's something important that you should hear, even though you can't hear me. I feel like it's important anyway. And I know that all this right now is things that he made. It's not Coda anymore, it's everything he's made. And look at how beautiful it is. How pretty. Keep hitting my microphone. Sorry. Oh geez, that's the beam at the end. That's probably the only thing we can do, right? Can I float up into the universe? I want to do that. Can I float up like I thought I would? Can I guess right again this time? Because I don't want to do the other thing. Or you could do the thing where I slow down now and I never make it there. You could do that too. I don't know what's gonna happen. This is the thing, this is the uncertainty, is I don't know what's gonna happen, which choice is it gonna make. I got through unscathed. But I can't move. I can't move. Oh! I am floating! but it's an endless maze. Holy shit. It's an endless, endless labyrinth. And I guess when you think about it, that's life, isn't it? It's just an endless maze. You're always going through and you never know if you're going the right way, you never know where you're gonna end up. But you just keep going. Because you'll get somewhere at some point. And look how pretty. Do you just keep floating forever, or...? It's gorgeous. Just to look at the sky. I'm assuming that's Coda. Or someone, I don't know. I also don't know if this is copyrighted music, and I really hope it isn't. This project would not have been possible without the following individuals. So that's all. That's the whole thing. And I'm glad someone told me to get tissues, because I'm still not doing so good. I don't even really know what to say about it. I guess I understood a lot just from my own personal experience. You know, having something that was an outlet for you once and then it doesn't really matter anymore. And even seeing myself in other people and seeing myself in their struggles, I guess. I'm trying to understand myself through other people. Don't understand why I'm not as good as them, or things like that. I'm not saying I necessarily feel like that now. Sometimes. Sometimes I do. And just that feeling of external validation. Like I said, you know, sorry I'm crying so much, I'm a big crybaby. If you should know one thing about me, it's I'm so sensitive. And I cry about a lot of stuff. I cried when I watched Lilo and Stitch. I still cry when I watch Lilo and Stitch. But just that need for validation from other people. Because you don't know how to feel it from yourself. I understand that a lot. And I guess that's why YouTube is such a nice thing, because I can create these things that I... create these things that I'm... you know, that I like and that I'm proud of them when I find out that other people like them too. And other people like me. And I know that sounds stupid. And I know that I'm crying a lot, and I'm really sorry. I want to stop crying, but I can't. I feel like it's the first step. It's the first step to really feeling good about myself. Is to have other people raise me up, I guess. And that's why I'm so thankful for you guys. And for the opportunity to talk to you guys, and you've helped more than I could really convey. More than I really realized until now. I didn't really understand exactly how I felt until just now, talking about it and realizing a few thousand more times. Just understanding
how this person felt and why, and understanding how I feel about you guys and YouTube and all that. And I probably look like a hot mess right now, but my makeup's still on. So this resonated with me quite a bit. And I just want to say thank you. Just thank you for being there for me. Thank you for lifting me up when I can't necessarily lift myself up. And I can't even begin to tell you how much it means to me, how much I appreciate the support and the kind words. It seems like every day there's someone new who has something nice to say to me about me, and it's just, I can't even accept your compliments because I don't believe them. But it's so sweet. It's so sweet of you to say. And like I said, I feel like it's the first step to really feeling, to feel like I'm able to accept and believe the kind things that you say about me. So I'm gonna stop crying now. because I'm just snorting into the microphone. I'm sorry for crying so much. But I just wanted to say what I wanted to say. I wanted to say what I did. And I really, really apologize if this video has a bunch of, is my makeup? Yeah, my makeup's fine. Sorry, I'm looking at it like, oh no, is my makeup coming off? No, it's good. I want to apologize if this video does have things like dropped frames and stuff like that, because I never know with my computer with recording for like 2 hours. So I hope that I avoided it. I know there was a little bit of lag at one point, but hopefully it's okay in all. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking. I don't want to stop talking. I don't actually want to leave. I don't want to stop recording, because when I do, then I'm just by myself again. But everything's got to stop at some point. And it's been an hour and 45 minutes, and it's got to stop at some point, so I'll leave it off here. After I dry my eyes, I will do my outro. I don't know if I can muster the whole thing, but I can at least say thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for being here with me for this almost 2 hour journey through the beginner's guide, and just thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for everything. So, bye. I'll see you in the next video. I didn't say that. Goodbye.